Bonjour, hello, oki, tenzi. My name is Mireille Perron and I welcome you in my Calgary studio. This is the fourth video of a short series of four videos where I was asked by the Esplanade staff to explain my project, The Anatomy of a Glass Menagerie, Altaglass, a project that will be presented at the Esplanade as soon as we are all safe from COVID-19 and that we could visit a museum again. So we hope probably sometime this summer. So in this last video, I will discuss briefly my next project or my ongoing project. I'm still working on it. Its working title is In Others' Word, Mood and Meaning. And it is a project that is using extruded clay, air fired ceramic, Tessie, and French knitting. So I will tell you a little bit about some idea in the project and why I use those two materials. The link with Altaglass, even if physically it looks absolutely different than cyanotype and using a collection here in the past project, Altaglass, what they have in common is that I am again being interested in my material culture, my local material culture and craft culture, and using a local product. So here the clay. Paper clay is you mix pulp with clay, but powdered clay, and then you make a slurry and then you dry it again. And I use the clay from Plainsman, different kind of Plainsman clay. The first time to a residency in Mid-Delta, this prototype come from Mid-Delta, and following up in a residency at my own university, the Alberta University of the Arts. So you need to put pulp in clay if you want to make structure that otherwise clay would have a hard time to be suspended to make shapes like that. They see that all by themselves. Or nuts, they would tend to crack. As the paper give like a kind of, imagine like when you are looking at bees doing honeycomb structure all the way through, and it support the clay well. So those components, so my idea is that material are like territory or languages and that they could translate one another. Many artists have done that through history. We often see things that are in metal that look like ceramic, things like that. But in my mind, also obviously because I often think I am myself as a human being in translation, I'm interested in this idea of how something could say something differently. So French knitting, and I like the fact that it was called French knitting. In French, we are not calling it French knitting, which is interesting. It's just called doll knitting to see. So you have commercial device, and that size was working for me, so I do. So this is what they look like. But I like to do my own because I like to control. When I did the extrusion, I was cutting my own extrusion, my die for the extrusion. So I had the size and the texture that I wanted. Like you could see here, you see little grooves in this one. So therefore, I thought that I would like to do the same thing for French knitting. So my two favorite one that I recommend, especially during COVID, French knitting is the thing to do, is that you take little pin and tube of cardboard. Those one is actually thread for when you are sewing. You see here I have 6 pin, so it's a more denser tube. And here I have 4 pin, it's a smaller and a bit less denser tube. In this one, this is a bit more flexible too because it's 5 pin and it's slightly bigger. And obviously here you could imagine you will also like a larger one that is, I forgot what tube it was, but and to knit, obviously it's easy. When I use pin, I actually prefer my needle. I'll just do one row here for you in case you see. If you want to see someone doing that at length, on the internet there is a lot of video about French knitting, but you see I roll around each pin and I loop around. You pull and it extend to see. So here in my basket, you could see that I have realm and realm of different, they are very long, I don't want to all think them, but you could see of similar color that I find at the custom wooden mill of the color that I use from to color the Plainsman paper cake. So here is my last one. I didn't want to remove the thread, so it shows that it comes from a tube from thread, because I wanted to use it. And it's just 3 pin, so that will be obviously looser to see. So my idea is that I see those as feminist pataphor, and a pataphor is when you invent your own metaphor, and that metaphor is the base for the reality of the second step. So here, obviously, is that I'm inventing the idea that that paper clay is obviously very translatable through French knitting, to see. And the overall idea is that obviously it makes me pay more attention here to clay, local clay, and to obviously a custom wooden mill, among other ideas around translation. So I hope that this project will also be something that we could share one day. In the meanwhile, keep safe.